Mohammed, it's absolutely fabulous to see you. You're the Senior Vice President of SAP Support. It's been a fabulous journey over the last number of years. Tell us some of the fun things you've been doing.
Oh, absolutely. Well, first of all, great to be with you again, Chris.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, the last few years have been, you know, quite intense in terms of our support transformation. At SAP Support, we're big believers of the effortless experience, as it's the new playground for customer loyalty.
Yep.
And everything that we're doing with regards to our transformation should meet one of two goals, which is, are we reducing effort on our customers, or are we reducing effort on our employees? So a lot of the technologies we've been using, and we've been using AI for the past 6 years, artificial intelligence, machine learning, robotic process automation. Uh-huh. Yes, Gen AI has accelerated our transformation. But all those technologies that we've been using in the past have been focused on the customer journey coming into SAP for me. And as customers come in, we have a lot of AI engines, machine learning engines that are firing off so that we can provide them their answer in the quickest and the easiest way possible. And if they cannot find their answer, then of course they log a case with us, and this is when we turn to the engineer effort. And we've provided them a lot of technologies and a lot of innovations to automate or eliminate repetitive tasks, so we can create more bandwidth for them so they can spend more time to deliver a better and faster service for our customers. Yes.
And of all those things, give me one that you're really, really proud of, one that really resonated with you or resonated with the customer.
I had an all-hands meeting last week, and I told the organization that, you know, many companies talk about an award-winning culture or award-winning organization. We in Support have won multiple awards. From TSIA a few years back, last year we won the Support Logic Award for transformational leadership and for support automation. This year, we didn't win, we came in second place with the Stevie Award for, again, customer service automation. But the one we're proudest of is the most coveted award inside SAP. It's called the Hasso-Plattner Award for Innovation. And we won it for Support Assistant and Support Log Assistant, which is an AI-driven automated workflow for when customers come into SAP for me, as I said earlier, and we're automating.
It's amazing.
That is our proudest achievement. To get Hasso-Plattner to recognize this.
Absolutely, it is a fabulous tool. I've used it. It is genuinely amazing. When we talk about, you know, the customers coming to you and their entry point, obviously we have SAP for me, but also with RISE customers coming in, the support organization, your organization is their first point of contact. How are you coping with that? And how are you adapting to those changes?
So let me take a step back here and talk about how we're guiding our transformation. Today, support organizations have three goals. Either they're predicting and preventing tickets, or deflecting tickets. Preventing means you haven't even hit the problem and we solved it for you. Deflecting means you had the problem, but with our self-service tools, search engines, et cetera, you found your solution. And where we spend the majority of our time is actually solving the tickets that come in. Any support organization operates the same way. We're trying to flip this around, where a lot of our effort and a lot of our resources are spent on prevention, then deflection, and of course, solving tickets. So as we cope with very high volumes, like with RISE, a lot of customers are signing up for RISE, which is great news for us, but it will come with additional volume. And this is where we're applying a lot of our technology, especially with generative AI.
Yes.
We have millions of cases. We have hundreds of thousands of knowledge-based article, community threads, and this is where large language models are coming in. So we unleash this technology to literally learn from the past to predict the future and turn the support experience into one where we're preventing problems in our products from creating a business interruption for you. So we're educating our RISE customers to, you know, leverage all these technologies that we have created in support.
The knowledge base is the level of data that you have related to your customers is absolutely unrivaled. And when you leverage generative AI to do those things and to surface the insights, to provide better user experiences, it's just absolutely phenomenal. And you've actually answered my last question, which is how are you leveraging generative AI? Because we have heard it so much here at Sapphire, and we've seen lots of really, really good things that have been announced and all the rest of it. But you know, as you said, you have been using these technologies for years, and you must be an example within SAP as to how you leverage and utilize generative AI to your customers' benefit.
We did. I did a couple of presentations, you know, this week here at Sapphire. We have 40 AI-driven use cases. Not all of them are Gen AI, because I said we've been using AI for the past 6 years. But today, between customer experience and support engineer experience, we have 40 live use cases. And if anybody is interested in learning more about that, we're very proud of that, and we'll gladly show them to you.
Fabulous, fabulous. Mohammed, thank you very much for your time. Oh, it's
been
always a pleasure.
It's been my pleasure.